Hey, what's up there, guys? Corey with Gotta Be Mobile on the Galaxy S5. Now, we're going to make this real short and sweet, but a lot of people have been asking us how to customize or change the lock screen on your Galaxy S5. And as you can see here, I've got this neat kind of effect on my GS5 to quickly unlock it. Now, we've been getting a lot of questions on all kinds of different things, but for those that want to customize or just change that lock screen to something different, it's actually super easy. So what you're going to want to do here is pull down the notification bar and go into settings. Now, there's a lot of different things here, but first, I've changed this to be a list view. There is a grid view out of the box, so maybe we'll do that to make this a little bit easier for some of you. So you go ahead and right here at the first initial setting screen, you see lock screen. So tap that, and of course in here you can change the screen lock for, you know, a PIN or a password or security or any of that, or even your fingerprint, but that's not what we want to do. Instead, what you want to go and scroll down a little bit. You can add that camera shortcut or get rid of it. If you're like me and you keep unlocking to the camera instead of the phone on accident, you can go ahead and kill that in settings. Another thing, dual clock. If you're in a different area, you're in San Francisco and you live in Las Vegas, it'll show you both, things like that. But come down here to unlock effect. If you like the one that I just showed you on the video to start, watercolor, it kind of has this like rippling watercolor effect. And then there's ripple. Popping colors is one of the ones that I think is on the phone out of the box. So go ahead and show that as well. Just kind of like this, like little bubbles. That's kind of neat here, and there's tons of little things, popping colors, stone skipping, and things like that. That'll just kind of change the way it looks when you're unlocking your phone. That one's not my favorite, but personally I ended up just going with watercolor, seemed to be the best one. Then you can add additional information. I put, you know, there's weather, you can do, you know, pedometer for how much you walk, and then let's see here, owner information. I went ahead and put, you know, my Twitter handle on there, but if you want to put something else, feel free. You put your phone number on there, your email or whatever. If someone, you know, finds your lost phone, you might get a good Samaritan that'll return it or what have you, but you can put your information on there if you'd like. And the other thing here, since you're wondering how I probably got this interesting blue kind of situation here on mine, is it is just a wallpaper. So just go into a screen and push and hold. And this is where you can customize your widgets and your apps and all kinds of things on the Galaxy S5. If you tap on wallpaper, you get a choice of the home screen or the lock screen or both. So if you want one picture to be both, you can do that. Or if you want them separate, you can do that too. Go ahead and tap lock screen, and this will change only the lock screen and leave your home screen completely, you know, completely alone. So I think that's what's out of the box. Kind of bright and a little too much for me. Pretty plain, and there's that one. Let's see what we got. A couple of them are pretty neat. And these are just lock screen options, so that one actually might be cool with the choice I have. Go ahead and set that wallpaper. And as you can see here, it didn't change anything because it's only my lock screen. So go ahead and unlock the phone again, and there you see the brand new customized lock screen. Pretty neat, kind of fancy. And that watercolor option makes it really cool. But there it is, guys. That's how to customize and change the lock screen on the Galaxy S5. Thanks for watching.